Your Excellency, you're most welcome.
The 24th Annual Judges Conference that was officially opened today in a colorful way is to be held between January 30th and February 2nd and is expected to see over 300 guests. The conference was officiated by President Yoweri Museveni and was graced by a number of dignitaries, including judges, justices, registrars, among others. The conference is aimed at providing an opportunity for judicial officers in the country to share experiences and discuss ways in which they can better carry out dispensation of justice to the public.
I've always said, and I reiterate here today, it is possible, it is not beyond our means. If we focus, if we put our priorities right, the judiciary of Uganda can make tremendous contribution to the socio-economic development of this country.
During the function, the Chief Justice Alphonse Owinyi-Dolo gave accountability to Ugandans on how courts have performed in the previous year, challenges and opportunities. He also outlined what is expected to be done in the coming year.
We intend to decentralize the Inspectorate of Court. We intend to make chief magistrates who will be in charge of districts strong inspectors of all the grade one magistrates under their care.
The Chief Justice also tasked government to provide the judiciary with more resources, human and financial. He has called for the recruitment of more judicial officers.
Your Excellency, my plea is kindly look at the recruitment of state attorneys so that this new vehicle which you are supporting, which you provided to go to Moroto, does not run out of fuel in Bugiri, because that is what is happening in the criminal justice system.
While presiding over this year's annual judges conference, President Museveni affirmed that Uganda is in a better position to rely on its security. Museveni noted that there was no need for external forces to provide security to Ugandans.
If you have got a wrong ideology, you will get the wrong results. Now, because of that, we are able to build a strong political force and also a strong army, the National Resistance Army. And that's why Uganda has been peaceful all these years, because of that capacity. Now, you can look at Africa. So many places you can talk about where they have got to call the UN to come and guard people. Why should you be guarded by UN?
Museveni says he's not open to allowing external forces to have a base in this country.
This is the problem of these other countries, the ones which are guarded by the UN, which I consider an insult, to be guarded by the UN as if we are imbeciles. I can't be guarded by the UN. UN will never come here in Uganda to guard us. It's an insult. We can defend ourselves, money or no money.
He further urged the judiciary to utilize the available facilitation from the government to promote justice in the country. He has urged lawmakers and the citizens at large to be patriotic.
When we were in the bush, controlling the Royal Triangle, we were having very serious justice without money. So again, I have a proof of that. In where I was the Chief Justice, I was both Chief Justice and President. I was combining both. We had justice, but no money. Just like I cannot agree, that one I cannot agree for sure, because I know it. And I've told all these people that it's not acceptable to say that a country cannot defend itself because they have no money.
During the 3 days conference, no cases will be heard because judges are attending the conference. But the registry is open and other judiciary staff are present to serve members of the public. Also, less court business is expected in the higher courts. However, magistrate courts will continue operating normally because they are not part of the conference. Report compiled by Shamshad Naluja for the news.